What time is it?
It's time for art!
Hey, fourth and fifth grade, welcome back. Who knew we'd be making more videos like this? Okay, the first thing I want to do is talk about my rules. If you're in fourth grade, this is your fifth time you have to listen to my rules. If you are in fifth grade, congratulations. This is your sixth and last time. I've got my rules posted all over the classroom, and they are not in words, they are in pictures. Now what I've done is I've drawn my rules because I like my rules to be pictures, because I know that everybody can read a picture. If you've ever been on an airplane, you'll notice that the safety instructions for the airplane are drawn in pictures and not written in words. Because an airplane is full of international travelers that speak a multitude and variety of different languages, but everyone can read a picture. What I've done is I've divided my rules like a comic strip. It kind of talks about the beginning, the middle, and the end of art. I've got them in my desk right here as coloring sheets in case I ever had an emergency sub. The emergency sub can just come in here, go in my desk, pass those out for the day, and have the kids color the rules. I've got them posted all over my room. Here in the back. Here in the back. Right here up front. And they're cycling through every 5 seconds on my smart board. So no one has any excuse to go home and say, I don't know what the rules are. At the beginning of art, the expectation is you will come in and sit at the table I told you to sit at. These kids right here are following directions and doing it right. These kids are not. They're coming in, going to whatever table they want to, talking to their friends, basically not ready to learn about art, and that's a bad thing. The next thing that happens, Mr. Penn has to talk in front of his class. Sometimes I talk a lot, like today, and some days I don't talk a lot. Whether I'm talking a lot or not talking a lot, it is your job to sit quietly so other kids in the class can hear my directions and learn. These kids right here are doing it right. I didn't even draw their mouths or their faces. These kids right here are not. They're talking and distracting kids from learning, making noise either with their mouth or their hands or their feet. Kids invent new ways to be disruptive all the time. So that's not a good thing. That's why it has a big red X on it. The third thing that happens is you go to your seat and you make art quietly. I love this little boy. He's working so quietly, I didn't even draw his mouth. These two girls are sharing the supplies, and this boy on the end is waiting patiently for his turn. But these kids have the big red X because now that boy that was working quietly is throwing his crayon, pencil, marker, colored pencil, whatever you want to call it, back in the box. We don't throw anything. We don't throw it if it's an eraser because it bounces. We definitely don't throw it if it's scissors. We don't throw wet paper towels, just drop them in the garbage can. To make this easy for you to understand, don't throw anything in the art room, ever. This little girl drew on this girl's paper. That's a big no-no in the art room. And that girl is not happy. She did not keep her hands to herself. Don't do that. And the boy on the end is not sharing. All of those are bad things. This year is going to look a little bit different because you're not sharing with four people at your seat. You're not sharing with anyone. Every table has two chairs at it. We're all socially distant. We've got plastic dividers separating the tables. So not all of these rules apply or look the same this year. At the end of class, we line up one person behind the next, hands by our side or behind our back. Everyone's facing the same direction and no one's talking. These kids have the big red X because they're doing it wrong. This girl's facing the wrong direction because she's having a conversation with this girl. The girl in the middle thinks she's my favorite student because she's yelling at the entire class to be quiet. That does not make you my favorite student. I don't know what the story is with these boys, why they're running or chasing each other or teasing each other, but we do not run in the art room ever. Okay, now that I've talked about my rules, one thing I want to talk about very quickly is my grading policy. I don't grade your artwork based on how pretty or how terrible it is. What I grade your artwork on is how well you are following directions, because that's what school's all about. An A is worth 5 points. An A is for the student that follows all instructions or does more with great craftsmanship. Great craftsmanship means I don't want it to be sloppy. A B is for the student that follows most instructions with good craftsmanship. That's for 4 points. That means you almost did everything I wanted you to do, but not quite. And it can't be sloppy. It's not as good as great craftsmanship. A C is for the student that does some instructions with good craftsmanship. That is also not sloppy. And to me, some means half. Why did a kid only do half? They're talking too much with their neighbors. They're going to the bathroom when it's not an emergency. They're sharpening 10 yellow colored pencils when all you need is one. They're playing games at the pencil sharpener. Those things waste time. So that means they only did half, but the half they did do wasn't sloppy. If they only did half their assignment and it was sloppy, well, that's a D. Does little work, poor effort, 2 points. And an F is for the student that does no work. And I don't really give out Fs. Our first assignment back, we're gonna shake the cobwebs off. We are going to draw a poster that illustrates healthy choices. For the last couple of years, a local business, Radiology and Associates, they have put out a calendar that encourages healthy choices all year round. For the first couple of years, it was all about healthy lungs and the importance of not smoking and the importance of exercise. In recent years, they've broadened the theme to include eating healthy and exercising. Well, this year, since we are in a pandemic, what they are encouraging you to do is not sit at home and just sit on the couch and eat snacks all day. They really are encouraging you to go outside and play and wear a mask and social distance. So that's what I want you to do this year. I want you to do your healthy choices poster. We're just gonna draw it this week. And I wanted to include something about social distancing or going outside and exercising. The theme for this year is let's play. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna draw 2 examples. You can feel free to use these as a jumping off point. Please don't copy these. The first one I'm gonna draw, let's just do a kid, instead of let's play, let's say go outside and have fun. Or how about go run, have fun. Or have fun, go run. We'll just do that. We'll draw a kid exercising outside with fresh air. The other picture I wanna draw, superheroes wear masks and we should be wearing masks right now to help lessen the spread of COVID-19. So let's just draw, I'll do big letters. It'll say, be a hero, wear a mask. And we'll draw a little kid wearing a mask behind a superhero wearing another mask. That's it for this week. See you next time. And time for my pro tip.
Okay, today's pro tip is an oldie but a goodie. What you see here is what I hope will eventually be the designs for the 2021 mural. What I'm working on is the light blue lines where I'm just kind of building up the shapes to figure out exactly how these characters will look. Like I'm giving this guy big old floppy rounded cartoon shoes, and I'll give this guy pointier looking leprechaun shoes. I'm doing this in the blue line so I can go back and add better details with a pencil and then finalize it up with my ink pen. So that's it for pro tips.
Bonus points! Fourth and fifth grade, we talked about healthy choices today. I want you to think of a bad habit that you have. And I want you to make a conscious effort to avoid doing that. That's it. Goodbye. See you next time.